Hey guys, welcome back to another first person view, point of view. This time we're rolling out with a warrior now. Mix it up just a bit like I was saying a bit before in the Monk gameplay videos. I did manage to level my warrior to 90 and that's what we're going to show today. It is back into the Jade Serpent Temple, or Temple of the Jade Serpent, whichever you want to say. So we're also going to mix it up a little bit today as well. Last night I did this incident, decided to record it, and we're going to do a bit of a post-production over-speaking? Voiceover, should I say. Instead of voice-overing while playing the game, I'm going to just do it afterwards. I had to record this last night, and I was unable to speak, so I figured I'd give it a shot to see if it's any better or any worse. And at least this way I can kind of prepare and have something. I don't know, I can check the footage, make sure it's good, and then if it is good, then I can be like, hey, alright, let's talk. If not, you know. It's not an issue. Throw out the stuff you need to throw out, and you go on from there. So going into this, being a tank is kind of changed. I don't know if it really has. I haven't really played anything else other than a warrior tank in MoP. I played everything in the beta once again, but that's not the point. The point is that we're live now. So basically, It's a bit different, right? Back in pre-mop, you had rage generation. Rage generation kind of works weird, depending on what stance you are. Being a tank, you have to be in defensive stance, so the way that rage generation works in defensive stance, that only shield slam and revenge actually generates the rage that you need. Any other rage is you don't get generated rage from being hit, you don't generate rage from doing hitting, you don't do anything like that. So it's kind of changed. So again, the idea when coming into as a warrior tank into this new MoP style of gameplay is basically you want to spam shield slam and revenge as much as humanly possible while trying to keep up your shield block nearly as 100% possible. Obviously there'll be times where you don't have the cooldowns to keep it up 100%, 100% uptime, but you can do your best. But it's fairly simple, straightforward tanking, style now. And hopefully we'll commentary about it. Basically, like I said, what you want to do, you can see here now. You keep your shield slam and revenge on cooldown while spamming devastate during downtime. Again, shield block needs to be up, and obviously it's not happening here, but that's not the point. But the thing is, It's kind of a weird choice to be in. I don't know. I'm not sure if I like this new tank style of play. I don't know. I'm not too sure. Either way, that's a bit weird. Let's just do this. Okay, whatever. It's kind of a tough choice, really, to decide whether or not you actually like the new. Is I don't know. It's kind of hard, but I like. Mainly in this tanking is the fact that you have two kind of shield blocks, right? You have your one that increases your melee, or just blocks physical damage, right? It gives you 100% chance to block, all that good stuff. The other one is one that just absorbs damage, flat out. It doesn't give you block, it just absorbs damage. Now, this does include spells in that, so it kind of gives, this whole new style of defensive play as a warrior when you're going up against caster mobs. Before, you'd just have to either interrupt if they could be, you'd have to spam shield reflex, and that's about it. You just have to, tank the spells to the face. But in the case that when a caster, or when a boss is a main caster, instead of using shield block, you use your other shield block that absorbs that damage, and instead, you can actually, limit the amount of magical damage you take incoming as well. So it's a very interesting style of play, and I really enjoy being a warrior in MoP, I think. I haven't played any of the others. Paladin tanking is fairly straightforward. It's not really anything to be worried about. I haven't done druid tanking and monk tanking either, so. Oh, death now. I knew I was forgetting something. I was like, there's another one I know, but yeah, so. So that's pretty much it. That's my thoughts on the warrior tanking, so hopefully. We'll get some more videos rolling out. Again, this is Jade Serpent, so I don't really need to talk about the instance. We do get to see in this video the second boss that is the one with the two guys we have to alternate. So you get to see what's going on there, but other than that, it's pretty much straightforward. So I'll let you guys deal. Have fun. Watch the video and enjoy Monk... not Monk tanking. Warrior tanking as a panda.
Face the trial of the Yungol. Let me shed some light. As the tale goes, the Yungol was traveling across the Kunlai Plains when suddenly he was ambushed by two strange creatures. Thank you. feeds on conflict. When you have peace in your heart, strife will find somewhere else to roam. You have my thanks, heroes. You have given peace. Now, off with you. I require meditation before I begin the restoration ritual.
good.